You're listening to the SWN podcast.
And this is SWN.
Welcome to SWN.
Skull! Skull! Skull!
This is SWN.
And this is the Scottish Wrestling Network.
Where Scottish wrestling lives, I guess. Is that a tagline? I guess. I don't know.
Next, I'm seeing we're sticking in Europe with Billy. Billy from the Scottish Wrestling Network. Billy, how are you?
I'm doing great. This is actually a really cool moment for me because I had like three VHS tapes for the young kids you won't know growing up, and one of them was Royal Rumble 94. So I get to speak to PCO, who of course had that match with the Bret and Owen Hart. I'm in heaven already. And now finding out that Mike's birthday was the 16th of July. My son was born in 16th of July 2022. So this is just a wonderful moment all around for me here. Amazing. I do have a question for the both of you. Is with Slammiversary on the horizon, and it got me thinking about all the creative matches that TNA have had in the past, and which you've been involved with. Is there a match type that you haven't yet had the chance to take part in that you'd be eager to try? So like PCO and Ultimate X, or Speedball and Monsters Ball?
When I came in 2003 in TNA, I came in the X division, and I had fun there, you know, for the time that I was there. But really, I mean, Mike was talking about winning all the titles with a different company. I've won all the titles in the company except the TV title. I've won the tag title. I won the six-man, the trio title, and I've won the world title. So I know what he's talking about. And since I've won all those titles with the company, now it's almost been 3 years with TNA, 2.5 or 2 and something. I'm going to my third year when I'm going to end up this contract. That'll be 3 years. And to me, like I said, it's always about always something like that more that to me it doesn't degrade any other titles, but to me it's like towards something, towards the world title, or towards something that's gonna step up in my career. Like that's the goal in itself.
Speedball.
So there's two matches that I really want to do, both of which I have proposed already. But I don't really have a reason to do them right now, but I've proposed them. I've talked about them with creative, and they have been promptly shut down. The first one being Elevation X that I would love to do.
I was just going
to
say that.
Right?
Yes.
I love the concept. I think the execution of the ones that have happened have all been fantastic. However, I can see why they might not want to do it. This is the other thing that I really want to do. I would like to do a Monsters Ball match, but the part where we're locked in a cage for 24 hours, I would like to live stream all of that. Stream those 24 hours so people up to the pay-per-view can connect and check in on what we're doing and see us bashing our heads in the cages.
Now, there's no food, no water, no light for 24 hours. Are you prepared for that part?
Well, yeah, that's the whole point.
Oh, I know. I'm just saying.
We do it all the time. So why not do it in front of the people? It's not a bad idea.
That's fair.
I knew PCO would be in for that one.
Oh, for sure. For
the
sure.
Nice thing about Elevation X is we still have Rhino on the roster. So, like, you know, I'm sure Terry would love to do that again.
Oh man, so that's some memories. I'm gonna have to go through the TNA Plus and seek out some Elevation X. So clean away my mind for a moment until you mentioned it. Thank you very much.
AJ Styles versus Rhino is genius. Like, if you watch it and then break it down, it is just pure genius.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. Billy, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you for your time and your question.